Welcome. This is the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston with the Expedition 29 update for Thursday, October 27th. Flight Director Jerry Jason is leading today's Orbit 2 flight controllers and serving as Spacecraft Communicator, or CAPCOM, is Christy Bertels. The Expedition 29 crew members, Commander Mike Fossum and Flight Engineers Satoshi Furukawa with the Japanese Space Agency and Russian cosmonaut Sergei Volkov, are completing the testing of the Russian segment's KURS automated rendezvous system and will close the hatch today on the Progress 42 vehicle in preparation for its undocking on Saturday. That undocking is planned for 4:04 a.m. Central Time. The departure of the Progress 42 sets the stage for the arrival of Progress 45, which will launch at 5:11 a.m. Central Time Sunday, 4:11 p.m. Baikonur Time. Docking to the pier's docking compartment is scheduled on Wednesday, November 2nd at 6:40 a.m. Central Time. Progress 45 supply ship is filled with food supplies and fuel for the station. On tap today for the crew, there are additional biomedical experiments and continuing maintenance work for the water on-off valve in the Columbus module. The crew is also holding a conference with the European Space Agency to debrief the water on-off valve encapsulation activity. More valves will be encapsulated in the coming months, and ESA is taking this opportunity to fine-tune those procedures. Fossum today will perform the final VO2 max and biorhythm runs for this expedition. VO2 max is the evaluation of maximal oxygen uptake and submaximal estimates of VO2 max before, during, and after long-duration International Space Station missions. This documents the maximum oxygen uptake of crew members onboard the space station during these long-duration missions. It's sometimes referred to as the VO2 peak and is a standard measure of aerobic capacity and is directly related to the physical working capacity of an individual. VO2 max is related to the ability of an astronaut to perform an egress task. That means the task required to leave the station while wearing a launch and escape spacesuit. The study is important because decreased VO2 max may represent a safety concern in the event of an emergency during spaceflight. The principal investigator for this experiment is Dr. Alan Moore at the Johnson Space Center's Human Research Program. And how does this study apply on Earth? Well, the data obtained provides valuable insight into the aerobic capacity of teams in closed environments, such as Arctic bases and submarines. Satoshi Furukawa is also closing out his nutrition and repository experiment with the final 24-hour urine collection. The nutritional assessment or nutrition experiment is designed to understand the changes in human physiology during long-duration space flights, and it measures the bone metabolism, oxidative damage, and chemistry and hormonal changes, as well as the assessment of nutritional status of the crew members. The results not only have impact on the nutritional requirements and development of food systems for future exploration missions, it also has influenced osteoporosis studies here on Earth. Dr. Scott Smith of the Johnson Space Center Human Research Program is the lead investigator, along with Purdue, Tufts, and Indiana University, and the University of Bonn in Germany are also participating in the study. Part of that experiment is the repository portion, and those specimens are collected and then brought back to Earth and kept at NASA's Biological Specimen Repository. That repository collects and stores and distributes samples to future investigators as they do continued human life science investigations. In other news here at NASA, the NASA TV will broadcast a tweet up at 11 a.m. Central Time out of Vandenberg, California, and the Kennedy Space Center. This is all in advance of tomorrow's launch of the Delta II rocket and the NPP satellite. The NPP satellite is the National Polar Orbiting Operational Environmental Satellite System preparatory project and is the first mission designed to collect critical data to improve weather forecast in the short term and increase understanding of long-term climate changes. NPP continues the observations of Earth from space that NASA has pioneered for more than 40 years. NASA TV coverage of that NPP launch tomorrow begins at 2 a.m. Central Time. Launch is scheduled for 4:48 a.m. Central Time at the start of a 9-minute launch window. For more information on the space station, on Expedition 29 and 30, be sure to look up the International Space Station homepage on the web and find us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter at NASA _International Space Station or NASA _Johnson. This is Mission Control Houston.